I don't know about you, but I'm always curious about the world and always aware of how much I still have to learn. The day that I'm not curious about anything will be a day that I personally don't want to see, as I'll either be a complete know-it-all or deluded or on my deathbed. Yet, in this increasingly connected world, experiencing information overload and a certain amount of burnout from that, to be honest, it's become critically important, and I do mean critically, to curate your learning experience and limit the information highway to some specific side streets and cul-de-sacs of your choosing. You like what I did there? I wanted to talk through how I've been easing back into my learning zone post my business sabbatical and what steps I'm taking to expand past my comfort zone, increase my skills and knowledge, and deepen my understanding and perceptions around areas I'm not often exposed to. But today, I wanted to focus on the benefits of learning something new and why you should want to do this in just about 50 minutes a day. Listen to episode 1 of season 3 at nataliesisson.com/15 if you want to learn more about this optimum time for learning. Anyway, I was reading a piece on Lifestyle Updated about the 7 benefits of learning something new, and the very first one was fun. I thought to myself, how often do we, especially as adults, do something for fun? The example they gave for this benefit was a friend who'd recently learned to surf and how much fun they'd had. And I thought back to the 20 plus surf lessons I took in Portugal last year and how I was constantly out of depth, no pun intended, and challenging my assumptions about what I was capable of while learning something new every single time, if not several new things. I quite enjoyed being a complete newbie to the sport and taking a mix of private and group lessons as well. And I loved how our instructor, Crazy Nelson as I like to call him, would draw diagrams in the sand and make models of waves in the sand to illustrate a point. And along with this, there was yelling and enthusiasm, practicing the technique on land, and of course, getting out in the ocean and doing it. Full immersion, so to speak, pun intended this time. Fun. Why on earth learn something if it's not fun? Everything that's taught can be fun, even accounting, especially when you're shown real case studies and examples that resonate with you and make your learning that much quicker and more effective. Another on this article's list that is obvious but often overlooked is a sense of accomplishment and pride. I know back in 2004 when I landed my biggest job to date as National Brand Manager for Schwarzkopf Professional Haircare, working quite long hours but loving learning on the job at speed, I also decided to take on more learning for the fun of it. It still amazes me that not only did I start training in January of that year for a body sculpting competition, I then decided to enroll at Otago University for an extramural one-year certificate in fitness management, just to go along with what I was learning through body sculpting. I was also going through Anthony Robbins' Awaken the Giant Within book and then working on some NLP, neuro-linguistic programming, for past events in my life while reading it. And I was listening to his CD series in the car on the way to work. And once I'd finished with his CDs, I recall listening to around 5 audiobooks, on CD of course, during my longish commute back in the days when I actually commuted. The results of this year were still my most impressive ever, at least in my mind. I got straight A's from university and some A pluses, proof that when you have experience in time management and a full-time job, you study much more effectively than when you're doing it full-time. I won my regional North Island body sculpting competition and went on to compete at nationals. And I had a rocking first year in my job, running the best ever New Zealand hairdressing awards, among other things, most ticket sales ever and under budget. And I felt immensely proud at what I was able to accomplish in just 1 year. Naturally, there were several things I had to give up in order to achieve that, like a life. No, I'm kidding, but I literally did eat chicken and broccoli all the time during my training, and my boyfriend at the time certainly didn't get the time and attention he deserved during 2004. So I'd hasten to add, learning should be fun, give you a sense of achievement, and fit in with your lifestyle, not take over it. Much like my take on business supporting your lifestyle too. So what else? Well, John LeBreton from Sydney, Australia, also shared 7 reasons why learning new things is important. What's with this magic number of 7? My favourite ones are, and I quote, "You can grow as a person, develop your knowledge base, and improve yourself for the better. Learning something new gets us access to new and different opportunities and the chance to try new experiences that might be the best ones you have ever tried. You could potentially earn more money in your work life from learning a new and appropriate skill, or by developing one that links to the work you do, and you'll rejuvenate your working life and get so much more from it. And finally, developing a new skill will influence the way you do things day to day, and they'll make doing things quicker and easier, saving time, energy, and stress. I don't know if you can save stress, but you can avoid it. While these are all obvious reasons, it's worthwhile letting them sink in, because at the end of the day, scheduling in time to learn and the actual act of learning takes time and effort, but the payoff can be phenomenal. To cap off the benefits, may I point you to a final article written by CCSU Continuing Education titled The Top 7 Benefits of Learning a New Skill. Seriously, again, 7 reasons? I swear I didn't search on that specifically on Google. Before I jump into those, I just want to say a huge thank you to the unwavering support of FreshBooks, our official sponsor here on Quest for Freedom. The working world has changed. With the growth of the internet, there's never been more opportunities for the self-employed. To meet this need, FreshBooks is excited to announce the launch of an all-new version of their cloud accounting software. And it's sexy. It's been redesigned from the ground up and custom-built for exactly the way you work. Get ready for the simplest way to be more productive, organized, and most importantly, get paid quickly. The all-new FreshBooks is not only ridiculously easy to use, it's also packed full of powerful features. Here are just a few of the ones Jessica Broom, entrepreneur and FreshBook customer, loves the most.
I do all my expenses in there. I have, you know, I use the app on my phone and I have a little ritual. Like every time I get on a plane, I'll take the, while I'm waiting for the plane to take off, I will do all my expenses from that day with all my receipts from the airport or whatever. I like that I'm able to do expenses in all different currencies and like instantly on my phone. So I never have that like get back from a trip and have, you know, 7 days of receipts build up. I think the time tracking is great sometimes, you know, rarely, but occasionally I will bill hourly and I like being able to just track my time like to the minute and then have it convert right into an invoice.
That's super cool. Yeah, I really love that. So your clients always know you're being truly legit with what you've done.
Truly honest.
Yeah.
Go to freshbooks.com/quest and check out their full list of amazing features. Then sign up and save yourself time and money today. Just enter Quest for Freedom where it says, "How did you hear about us?" I'd really appreciate it. And so would they. The three most important ones they stated, in my opinion, are, and I quote, your brain chemistry changes. The white matter in your brain is called myelin, and it helps improve performance on a number of tasks. The more people practice a new skill they're learning, the more dense the myelin in their brain becomes, which helps them learn even better. So, let's all make our myelin dense. Your learning speed increases. Learning a new skill helps you learn things faster over time. By stimulating neurons in the brain, more neural pathways are formed and electrical impulses travel faster across them as you attempt to process new information. The more pathways that are formed, the faster impulses can travel. So it's a benefit. Learning more allows you to learn more quickly. And you could stave off dementia. People who learn new skills are less likely to develop dementia, which has been linked to demyelination of your brain. People who actively learn new skills don't give their brains a chance to demyelinate, and their neural pathways are ready for new impulses to travel along them. So basically, your brain stays younger for longer. And perhaps the most important reason of all, though, is this. Learning something new will make you happier. According to an article in Psychology's, I quote, it's actually a core need for psychological well-being. Learning can help us build confidence and a sense of self-efficacy. It can also be a way of connecting with others too, says Vanessa King, positive psychology expert at Action for Happiness. As human beings, we have a natural desire to learn and progress. Psychologists call it mastery. There is evidence to suggest that adult learning seems to have its most positive impact on self-esteem and self-efficacy when the learning provided meets the needs of the learner, and when the learner is at a stage in their life when they're ready and receptive to benefit from it. Learning also fuels our creativity. Ideas can come from making connections between seemingly unrelated things, says King. Learning something new in one area of our lives can trigger ideas in another. So, curiosity and creative thinking go hand in hand. And this can also help with creating what psychologists call flow, or being in the zone, when we're so absorbed in what we're doing, we lose sense of time and of ourselves. It's not passive like when watching TV, it's active, explains King. When we're in flow, the level of challenge in the activity just exceeds our level of skill. We're also getting instant feedback from the activity on whether what we're trying is working, so we can adjust what we're doing accordingly. As our skill increases, so does the challenge. So, there you have it. More than 7 reasons to learn something new. 11, in fact. And the reason I've researched into this above and beyond my natural curiosity is that it's important to have a foundation of your why. A strong why linked to learning on a daily basis is going to keep you motivated during times when you feel you can't afford the time or energy to learn. And in the next episode, I'm going to be covering off on exactly that, the how of effective learning and hacking techniques to learn more in less time, as well as the what on earth should you actually be learning? Tune in on all good podcast platforms like Stitcher, iTunes, and Anchor. And you know what? If you feel so inclined and you're enjoying this season, please leave me a little review. I'd be so happy. And I'd learn something new. I'd learn about what you're enjoying and liking about this podcast and what else you want to hear. Over and out.